This is KCAL News, Los Angeles.
Well, down 530, LA is another step closer to becoming an official sanctuary city. The move comes as immigration continues to be a hot button issue leading up to the 2024 election.
And KCAL News reporter Jeff Nguyen has details on today's city council vote and what it means going forward.
12 ayes.
12 ayes. Congratulations.
In a unanimous vote, the LA City Council passed a motion requesting the city attorney to draft a sanctuary city ordinance. Bruno Weezer says he was separated from one of his parents in high school because of deportation.
Displacement happened. We lost our family. We lost our home.
The proposal would put down in law existing policies which prohibit any city resources, property, or personnel from being used for any federal immigration enforcement. The divide between local jurisdictions and the federal government was recently highlighted when Florida sent migrants to Sacramento. Ira Melman with the Federation of American Immigration Reform says, don't be surprised if we see that happening in LA.
It's hard to imagine how they can be complaining on the one hand about the fact that a governor in another state is sending migrants and at the same time doubling down on the idea that anybody who shows up in Los Angeles is going to be protected.
I do believe that there is absolutely a responsibility on government and for all of us, you know, to look at the ways in which that we could better fund these programs, ensure that no one has to sleep on the streets.
Bruno Weezer says he wouldn't have been separated from a family member who had been convicted of a crime if the local government hadn't cooperated with U.S. Immigration and Customs officials.
My parent was subject to double punishment after serving their time, getting released by a judge from state prison. They were then subject to detention and deportation that was never handed down by a judge.
It should be the objective of local communities to remove people who don't even belong there, who have shown that they have a propensity to commit crimes.
After the city attorney's office delivers a draft on the ordinance, the council will have another round of discussion before members vote on whether it becomes law. In downtown Los Angeles, Jeff Nguyen, KCAL News.